back dear students and friends. Now today we are going to start with a new chapter. It is chapter number 5. It is principles of inheritance and variations. Okay, so here today we are going to start with the new chapter, principles of inheritance and variation. Okay, so today we are going to learn with this chapter principles of inheritance and the variation. Before I start with this chapter, principles of inheritance and variation, I want to ask a few questions and try to find out the answers of this. Then it will be a lot easier to understand this chapter. Okay, this is a very basic. Like you know that the elephant that gives a birth to an elephant only, the elephant cannot give a birth to a horse. Similarly, from the egg of a sparrow, only the sparrow that gets hatched out. From the egg of a sparrow, the chicken cannot be hatched out. Okay? Why this is going to happen? Similarly, the human being, it can give a birth to a human being. Okay? But the human being cannot give a birth to a monkey. Okay, this is what going to happen usually. Okay, from a mango seed, only the mango can generate. From a mango seed, the apple or the pineapple cannot be generated. Why this is? How this is? Okay, we have to try to find out these answers in this chapter. Even if you see that, now you know that the human being produces the human being, the mango seed produces the mango, and the egg of a sparrow, it will only generate a sparrow. But when the human being generates a human being, the another human being that is produced or the offspring that is produced is not exactly similar. Okay? Or the two cousins, okay? Or two siblings, okay? They are not exactly same. They are similar looking, or they are similar looking with a parent, or they are similar looking with a sibling. But they are not exactly same. So how this is going to happen? That we have to learn in this chapter, that what we call it as principles of inheritance and the variations. So there is a branch of biology which will deal with such kind of answers. And this branch, we are calling it as genetics. What we are calling it as? Genetics. Okay? So genetics, this is a word that is derived from a Greek word. Okay, in a Greek, the gen, meaning of gen is to become. It's to become. Okay, that means how the new human being is produced. Okay, from the parent, how the mango is produced from its seed. Okay, so that we are learning in this branch of a biology, what we call it as genetics. So the genetics is a word that is derived from a Greek word, what we call it as gen. Gen means to become. Okay, so what is a genetic? I will define the genetic. What is a genetic? It is a branch of biology which deals with heredity and variation, which deals with. In the genetics, you have to learn the two principles. First one is heredity, and the second one you can call it as variation. So what is the definition of genetic? Genetic is a branch of biology which deals with the heredity and the variation. This is called as genetics. Okay, so now let's discuss what is an heredity. Okay, here the genetics is based on the two principles, heredity and variation. So that is the name of chapter, principles of inheritance means heredity, and the second one is a variation. Okay, so that we are going to learn over here. So let's discuss what is a heredity. What is a heredity? Heredity, that means it is a process of transmission of characters from parent to offspring or progeny. You can also call it as progeny. That means next generation. Okay, so what is a heredity? Heredity, that means it is a process of transmission of characters from parent to offspring, or you can call it as progeny, or you can also call it as next generation. Okay, so the character from your parent that is transferred to you, that is called as heredity. This is called as a heredity. Okay, similarly, the another term that is called as a variation. Though the characters are transferred from a parent to an offspring or the progeny or the next generation, the parent and the offspring or the next generation are not exactly same. They are similar looking but not exactly same. So there is some variation exists. A variation exists between the parent and the next generation, and this is called as variation. Okay, so it is a kind of an factors by which no two one resembles the same. Okay, this is called as a variation. Okay, so variation is a influences by which two offspring are not similar, or they have a variety, okay, they have a variation exist in them. This is called as a variation. Okay, it is the factor or the influences by which the two one or the two living organism in the species, they do not like the same. Okay, so this is called as variation. So in this is the base of heredity or base of genetics, what we call it as heredity and the variations. In the whole chapter, we have to focus on these two terms, heredity and the variation. In short, if I tell you in the simple Gujarati language, then what is a heredity? Heredity એટલે જેના લીધે તમે તમારા parents જેવા લાગો છો, or the characters which are going to be transferred. And the variations, that means એવી વસ્તુ કે જેના લીધે તમે તમારા parents અથવા sibling કરતા slight અલગ છો. This is called as a variations. So, which characters are transferred? In which circumstances they are going to be transferred, by which you are varying with your parents and the siblings, that we have to learn in this chapter, principles of inheritance and the variations. And this is a branch called as genetics. Okay, because the genetics that deals with heredity and the variations. Okay, so here we have to learn regarding this in this chapter. Okay, I hope so it is clear to everyone what we have to learn. Now these principles of genetics, that means heredity and the variations, are not the newer. Okay, you might have heard that we were also doing a selective kind of a breeding in the ancient times. Even these practices were too older, but at that time we were not doing it scientifically. But still, we are generating a better product, a better offspring, or the better next generations by performing a selective breeding, and we have also achieved a selective breeding. Okay, what we are performing in case of a plants, what we were performing in case of an animals, etc., we have done this. This is not a new, but the scientific study of such kind of a principles that have been done in the mid 19th century by the scientist, or you can say a priest, okay, Gregor Johann Mendel. Okay, the Gregor Johann Mendel, famously known as a Mendel. You might have studied in the 10th standard, the Mendel have started such kind of experiment scientific. Okay, so who has started such kind of a experiment? The experiments of heredity and the variations, it has been started by Gregor Johann Mendel. So this is the name of a scientist. Gregor Johann Mendel. Okay, this person has started the experiment of heredity and the variation scientifically. That's why we are calling this person as a father of genetics. This person is considered as father of genetics. Okay. This Gregor Johann Mendel has performed his experiments on a plant. Which plant? Garden pig. He has performed its experiment on a plant called as garden pig. Scientifically, we are calling it as Pisum. This is the scientific name of it. Pisum sativum L. Okay. The Mendel, okay, famously known as a Mendel, Gregor Johann Mendel, has performed his experiments on the garden pea. What we call it as Pisum sativum L. And this, I have already told you that this were the not new practicals or new experiments. We were doing this, but this person has done scientifically. And this person has achieved a success. Why this person has achieved a success? There are few reasons why this person or the Mendel experiments are successful. Okay, so let's discuss why Mendel experiment are successful. So this is a question which might going to be asked, why Mendel experiments are successful? Why we are calling it as father of genetics, though he was not the first person who has started it, okay? But yes, he has started scientifically, okay? So why his experiments are successful? First reason, he has selected a plant called as garden pea, okay? And this garden pea or the Pisum sativum L, it is easy to cultivate in the ground. This is the first reason, okay? The plant or the pea plant, I give the name pea plant, garden pea, is easy to cultivate. Okay, this is the first reason. It is easy to cultivate in the ground. So that's why the Mendel experiment are successful. There are lots of reasons we were discussing why this Mendel experiment are successful. One of the reason is the garden pea or the pea plant is easy to cultivate in the grounds. Okay, this is the first reason. The second reason why the Mendel experiment are successful. The second reason is that this pea plant, okay, the garden pea plant is self-fertile. They are the self-fertile. Okay, this is the second reason. Okay, they are self-fertile. That means you don't have to do a certain kind of artificial procedures and the way. Okay, this is, you don't have to perform. So it can generate the next generation very easily because the garden pea plant is a self-fertile. Okay, even what is the another reason? The hybrids, we are generating the hybrids over here. The hybrids of it, pea plant, are also fertile. Not just the pea plant, but the hybrids which we are produced. Hybrid, that means by mixing the two character, the new plant which is produced, that we are calling it as a hybrid. The hybrid that is produced, it is also again a fertile. So that hybrid is also capable of generating a next generation. So this is a third reason. Okay. The fourth reason is that why these Mendel experiments are successful. That means cross pollination means transfer of pollen grain from one plant to another plant. This cross pollination is not difficult. Here it is very easy that to perform that cross pollination, it is very easy. So he want to generate a hybrid, whatever he desires, it is possible because the cross pollination is not difficult. Okay. The next reason why the Mendel experiment are successful is that the artificial hybridization is a more successful procedure. Here the artificial hybridization is successful. There are very few chances of it's a failure. So every time the next generations are going to be produced. This is the reason why the Mendel experiments are successful. Okay. Next reason why the Mendel experiments are successful. So the garden pea plant have number of contrasting characters. It is doesn't have a just a one contrasting characters. It have a lots of contrasting character. So like I give you example. One is a tall plant and the second one is a short or the dwarf plant. This is a one contrasting character, height. One has a yellow flower and the second one is a white flower. This is another contrasting character. Someone has a round surface, the other has a wrinkled surface. Okay? Someone has an axial flower, someone has an apical flower. There are lots of contrasting characters. There are more than 14 contrasting characters you can find. And that's why it is easy to identify. Okay, whether it is a tall or short, whether it is a white or it's a yellow, whether it is a round or wrinkled, because it is easy to differentiate between these two characters because these characters are contrasted. So they have a lots of or number of contrasting characters. Usually in a garden tree pea plant, we can find a 14 number of contrasting characters. This is one of the reasons why the Mendel experiment are successful. Okay, so it has a lots of contrasting character. The next reason why the Mendel experiments are successful, that he has done a statistical analysis. Statistical analysis of a given data, and that's why he was the first scientist who has applied the mathematics in biology. Here we will also apply the mathematics in biology to find out the answers of a few important questions which might going to be asked in entrance examination. Okay, we will apply the mathematical equations which you have studied in the 8th standard, 9th standard, 10th standard, like a plus b whole square is equal to a square plus 2ab plus b square, or a cube plus b cube, what is the equation? Similar kind of equation we applied. He was the first scientist who has applied such kind of a mathematics or the statistics in the given data, and he is able to identify the significance. What is the significance or the importance of this project? This is one of the important reason why the Mendel experiment is successful. Okay, why we are believing the Mendel? Because we were doing, but we were not doing the scientifically, we were not applying any kind of a statistical analysis to it. So we do not get a significant data or we do not get the significant result. But here, yes, he has applied, so he is able to show that he got the significant result. Okay, this is one of the reason. And the last reason why the Mendel experiments are successful, so the here the sample size, he took the sample size large, and when he took this large sample size, it will be a benefit to it, because when you are considering the four people, okay, like suppose if I am asking you question that there are the four students, and if I ask a question that like for an example, which person you like as an PM? Okay, I will give you two options. One is Narendra Modi, and the second one is you can say that the Rahul Gandhi. Take out the answers. The majority of you will choose either of one. Okay, but that doesn't reflect the whole country. Okay, suppose assume that like all four have selected only one person. Like for an example, all four have selected this Narendra Modi. So that indicates that 100% people likes this. But that is not the case in the country, because here the sample size is small. So when we are performing the experiment on the small sample size, you might get a false result. Like I have performed the experiments on four people. I have just asked the one question, and I told them to give answer, and all four have given the same answer. If I replicate at a larger scale, that indicates that 100% people like the Narendra Modi. But that is not the correct one. Okay, there are also few people also likes the Rahul Gandhi. That might going to happen. So if you take the small sample size, you get a false result, you get an incorrect result. But when you take a large sample size, if I ask for thousands of people, I might get a correct result. And the same thing he has done, he has not taken just one plant, two plant, three plant, four plant. He has taken the thousands of plants at a time. So the sample size of his experiment is large enough, and so that's why he is able to formulate the different laws. We will study the different laws that have been formulated or recognized by this scientist Mendel. So these are the reasons why the Mendel experiments are successful. I again repeat it,
You have to remember this question might going to be asked in 3 to 4 months. Why the Mendel experiments are successful? First, he has done his experiments on a garden pea, that is a Pisum sativum L. This garden pea plant is easy to cultivate in ground. No special type of fertilizers and the manures and the, you can say chemicals they are going to be required for its growth. It can be easily grown. That is one of the reason. Second, the garden pea plant is a self-fertile. Means the hard working in fertilizations or the production of next generation is little much. Hybrids even which are going to be produced, they are also perfectly fertile. Even the hybrids which are produced, like I have taken a tall plant and the short plant. By mixing this, I have generated a hybrid. Okay, that hybrid is also perfectly fertile. So this is one of the reason. Okay, next, the cross pollination is not difficult. It can be easily achievable. Even the artificial hybridization is the most successful in this case. Garden pea plant that contains a lots of contrasting characters, so it is easy to identify. Okay? Because you can easily identify between the yellow flower and the white flower. Okay, so the number of contrasting character, not just a one, but it has 14 contrasting characters in it, so it is easy to identify. This is one of the important reason he has applied the statistics in the data what he obtained. So he get the significant result and he is able to show that I get the significant result. And even he has taken the large sample size. Okay, so that's why the data that is going to be formed, they are the consistent data what he get and can able to form or formulate the different laws of genetics. Okay, this is a reason, these are the different reasons for the success of Mendel experiments. Otherwise they are not new. And as his experiments are successful, we are calling it as father of genetics. So Gregor Johann Mendel is considered as father of genetics, popularly known as Mendel. And genetics that deals with the study of heredity and the variation. Two things, heredity and the variation. Heredity means it is a process of transmission of character from parent to offspring. And the variation, that means a process or the factors or the influences by which two individuals are not exactly similar, but they have some variations, okay, in them. So this is called as a variations. This is all about the Mendel and the introduction of principles of inheritance and the variations. In the next session, we will start with the experiments what the Mendel have performed. Okay, this is a very basic, learn it properly. It may happen that you have learned a Mendel experiment, monohybrid experiment in the 9th and 10th standard, but that is at a primary level. Here it is a very base. We will start from that primary level and we will go in a deep. Okay, and this is very, very, very much important chapter because 4 chapters are associated with it, which are comes under the genetics. Okay, genetics and biotechnology. So learn it thoroughly, and it also has a higher weightage in the examination. So learn it thoroughly. Keep learning, keep watching, like and subscribe this channel. Thank you for watching.